Hi, Jesse Colin Young. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good. In New York, it's snowing like crazy.
Wow. Okay, it's only raining here. Well, thank you for speaking with us. I know I have a very limited time with you. You have a new album out on BMG, first one in 13 years of all new original songs that you've written. Tell us about the album.
My son was graduating from Berkeley, and I went to hear his senior recital, and he was playing with a bunch of young people. And I just said, they blew me away, and I said, I want to play with a young band. So we put a band together. And after we'd played a half dozen gigs, I knew I wanted to record with them. So I began writing, and it actually started before that. Connie and I wrote the first song, Connie, my wife, called Cast a Stone, which is the lead song on the album. This album was made in, you know, probably 13 days or less.
Wow.
Yeah, and I was pleased to find a singing like a bird.
You really are. And is your son in the band?
Yeah, he's the bass player.
And then is your daughter in it too?
No, she's making kind of poppy records on her own. We tried to get her to open some shows for us, but that's not happening yet.
Are you going to be touring with this album?
Mm-hmm.
Are you coming to Philadelphia?
Well, I sure hope so. I mean, how could we miss Philadelphia?
The tour is not lined up yet?
No, it's not.
Okay. Well, I saw the video for My Sisters, and that song addresses a current topic right now. Is that the only one that is sort of like current topic?
No, Cast the Stones really was triggered by the Boston bombing. Shapeshifters is the final line of the chorus. It's about people who lie on television and lie on news shows, and if lies can win, we are bound to lose. If we lose sight of the truth, I mean, we're operating in the dark. So, Poor Orlando is the song I wrote after the Orlando massacre. I mean, how do we get over that? And then there's a song called Dreamers, and says we're all. In my opinion, we're all dreamers. We're all immigrants in this country, whether our people came here 4 years ago or 400 years ago. Dreams of immigrants are part of the strength of the backbone of this country. So the chorus, don't turn your back on the dreamers. Dreams make our country strong.
You have a unique perspective on history because you were in New York during the folk scene that spawned Richie Havens and Bob Dylan and Felix Pappalardi and people like that. And then you moved to San Francisco for the Summer of Love. Tell me about those times.
Well, we're playing San Francisco for the first time. We had just toured on the East Coast, and that was it, in the Youngbloods. And I remember walking into this little motel we're staying in down the street from the Avalon Ballroom, and I was wondering why all these people in the street were smiling at me. I mean, I grew up in New York, and people, you know, they don't smile at you in the street, or they didn't then. Then I turned on the radio, and there was Get Together. We had no idea that we had a hit record in San Francisco in June of 1967, and there it was. And we went down the Avalon Ballroom. It was full of, I'd never seen so much hair in my life. And then the light shows, I mean, so I was like a child walking into, I don't know what, Wonderland. And I mean, we all looked at each other after that first show and said, we're going to move here, right? And yeah, we did. It was a beautiful time. The audience was the part of the music. It wasn't so much distinction. And of course, I mean, the tickets were, what, $3 or $4? I don't know.
Right. Well, I'm sure you have, like, so many great stories. Let me go to when you toured with Led Zeppelin. What year was that?
You know, I don't remember. I didn't tour with them, but we played this one show together in Seattle. That was really a great pleasure.
So is that when you got to know Robert Plant? Because I know he covered your song Darkness, Darkness.
That's when I found that my roadie came back and said, Plant's a fan of yours. I said, really? Wow. And then years later, he called me up on the phone from the back of a taxi and said, I'm recording Darkness, and I want you to listen to the, we did five different mixes, and I want to know if you think I did a good job in the song. And I was living in Hawaii at the time, and I'm on my porch. He's in a taxi. I guess it's night in London. And he sent the mixes over, and I thought he did a wonderful job. I loved it.
And then he won the Grammy for Best Rock Vocal for that.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Well, Jesse Colin Young, thank you so much for speaking with us.
All right. My pleasure.
All the best with your album, and I do hope to see you in Philly when you come on tour.
Oh, good. Yes, do come and see us.
All right. Yes. Take care, Jesse.
You too.
All right. Bye-bye.